First, let's look at some normal children in nursery school. Recalling normal behavior will help in recognizing the abnormalities of the psychotic child. Most children of this age enjoy being around each other. They like to watch and rub elbows. Normal children are very aware of the teacher, are interested in her, and attentive to her activities. Imitation is common in healthy preschool relationships. Three-year-olds cooperate in play and show a lively interest in each other. Play is meaningful and full of emotion. Although we cannot hear them, be assured that they are a talkative, noisy, giggling, squealing group. No matter how simple the play of the normal 3 or 4 year old may appear, it has a definite purpose. Both normal and abnormal children attend the nursery school we see here. John entered nursery school at 3 years of age. He had no language. Note the peculiar flapping of hands as he dances on tiptoe. Initially, much of his time was spent in aimless wandering, seemingly watching nothing in particular. He could easily be led to the swing because this was the only activity he seemed to enjoy. He was often frightened by the sounds of normal children at play and by the camera. John effectively avoided the other children and managed to be by himself. Any interest in play materials was brief. The teachers were aware of his illness and spent a good deal of time with him giving support. Here he exhibits one of his typical mannerisms, tapping his lip with his finger and waving his hands. He never initiated change, so had to be led indoors or outdoors. Indoors, he often paced about in a repetitive pattern, or just stared into space. When an occasional child approaches him, he pays no attention. He does not speak. He just wards off the intruder. He is unable to relate to children in any normal fashion. His habit of climbing onto the toy cabinet and remaining there for long periods may have served to isolate him from the others. A lack of normal relationships with others is a cardinal sign of infantile psychosis. He takes some raffia from the nearby flower basket and shakes it and chews it. He could engage in such monotonous activities for long periods. He isolates himself on a table, then finger taps. Abnormal motility is best seen in his pacing. He also liked to twirl in circles. A disturbance in motility is also a predominant sign of infantile psychosis. Here the abnormality is noticed in the hand movements. Although he would occasionally approach a toy, he always stopped short of using it for its intended purpose. Still another significant sign of infantile psychosis is disturbed relationships with objects or play materials and toys. John simply mouths the pegs instead of placing them in the pegboard. Then he strokes the toy with a repetitive finger movement. These home movies of John, beginning at 12 months of age, indicate a deceptively normal appearance. He was capable of quite a show of emotion, especially with his father. Most of the time, his face had little expression. With his mother, he was always distant. The parents' history and these pictures at 12 months show less responsiveness than expected in the normal. His mother preferred not to hold him for feedings. She fed his bottle in this manner. Absence of anticipatory posture to being picked up is a frequent early sign. A peculiar mannerism was stroking the floor. He approaches a toy, but taps at it instead of reaching for it and handling it as one might expect. He apparently liked to stroke the floor for the sound it produced. At 18 months, he spoke no words, but his hearing was normal, as indicated by his ability to locate airplanes. Here at 18 months in a public park, he is fearful of these children. In his distress, he fails to recognize his mother, but crawls to a strange woman. At age 2, he is in the midst of toilet training. He can say "Hi, Daddy" at this age, but later loses these words. Here we will see an abnormal motility pattern already evident. As he runs, note his rapid hand movements. Now almost 3, John still wishes to avoid his mother. He prefers to remain at a distance. It was not until 2.5 that John's parents became concerned and suspected him abnormal when language had failed to develop. Although the outlook for recovery from infantile psychosis is very poor, we can observe some changes and improvement in John during his year at nursery school. Music became his first sustained interest. His attention is noticeably drawn when records are played. The music seemed to soothe him. After a year in school, he would even get on the rocking horse. The face we see now makes it hard to believe he was so animated at 12 months. Now it's difficult to imagine what is going on in his mind. It was not until John had been in nursery school for almost a year that he could be interested in finger painting. Now he shows an awareness of this play material and the teacher's attention, which is a bit late. His play here represents quite an improvement in his relationship to materials and toys. He notices the paint fall to the floor. He realizes he has a finished product. The camera catches a rare glimpse of curiosity. John was seen to make occasional bids for attention from the teacher. One teacher in particular played with him on a level that he really enjoyed. Twirling was his favorite activity. This is the way he showed his best relationship with the teacher. He made squealing sounds when he was pleased. He made some progress in relationships with other people too. He came to accept men especially, even though total strangers. He would lean against them or crawl into their laps. However, he avoids face-to-face meeting. He manages to maneuver himself back into a position facing away from the person. Seemingly delighted with his new acquaintance, John dances merrily about the room. Then, as if motivated by the attention he is receiving, he evidences appropriate play as he steers a small car about the floor. This is the first time he has engaged in this type of play. Now 4 years of age, John leaves school on one of his last days. He still has no language and is not yet toilet trained. However, he is much more aware of his environment than he was a year ago. Although not normal, he can now make some relationships with people and play appropriately with some materials. Unfortunately, the ultimate prognosis remains poor in infantile psychosis, even under the best and most intensive treatment.